Imagine starting your day without a cup of coffee. You can't, right? Human interaction would be a living hell. But how does it work? What does caffeine do to your brain? Did you know caffeine doesn't give you energy at all? It actually tricks your brain into thinking you are not tired.
Whether we are sipping it to get going in the morning or pounding it to stay awake later at night, our favorite psychoactive drug is caffeine. Caffeine is the most widely used mind-altering substance in the world. Caffeine is a natural stimulant most commonly found in tea, coffee, and cacao plants. It works by stimulating the brain and central nervous system, helping you stay alert and prevent the onset of tiredness. And it does a fantastic job of mimicking a particular biochemical called adenosine. Adenosine is a compound which builds up in your brain the longer you are awake. Adenosine bonds with receptors on the brain cells, slowing them down and making you feel tired.
But how caffeine works on your brain?
When you drink a cup of coffee or a can of soda, the caffeine gets in your bloodstream and makes its way to your brain. That's where it meets the adenosine. Since caffeine and adenosine look so similar, the receptor cells in our brain happily bind with caffeine instead of adenosine. Basically, caffeine is stopping adenosine and slowing things down by taking its place. So, your brain cells stop getting slow and make you feel active. Of course, what comes up goes down. The receptor eventually let go of that caffeine and lets the adenosine back in after 6 hours. You will only feel half of caffeine effect and you are going to stop to drag. So, the next morning when you wake up, you are already feeling the symptoms of withdrawal. And dare on desperate attempt to get things back on track by reaching for another cup of coffee.
Caffeine also helps in lifting your mood.
Since caffeine acts as a stimulant for the central nervous system, it actually improves your mood. This is due to the same adenosine blocking effect that makes you feel energetic. When you block adenosine with caffeine, the brain releases extra glutamine and dopamine, which are other natural stimulants responsible in making you feel alert, less bored, active, and as a result, you have boosted your mood.
Caffeine can boost your memory.
Scientists have found that about 200 mg of caffeine can improve your memory up to 24 hours. It may also help you cope with dull tasks as well as recalling straightforward information.
Caffeine can relieve headache.
Caffeine actually restricts the blood flow in your brain, which can be useful effect when it comes to treating headache. A lot of headaches can be cured by consuming caffeine in the form of coffee or black tea.
Caffeine improves physical performance.
Since caffeine is a stimulant, it can help prepare the body for physical activities an hour before performance. Caffeine is actually one of the most common stimulants used in sports to enhance performance. Caffeine also breaks down fat cells, which are used as a fuel in training. This not only ensures performance, but can burn up to 50% calories.
Caffeine can cause frequent urination.
It may cause you to urinate more frequently. Researchers have shown that the caffeine has a direct effect on the bladder, which can irritate the tissues of your bladder, which can cause voluntary bladder contraction.
Caffeine promotes bowel movement.
Many people find when they drink coffee in the morning, they typically have to go to bathroom shortly after, and this easily becomes a habitual practice. Nevertheless, caffeinated coffee is 60% more effective to get the day going more than water, because coffee relaxes the muscles in your colon, making the process easier. Relaxation in the intestinal muscles, which promotes bowel movement. For those with constipation, this can be very useful, as a caffeine can act as a natural stool softener.
Let's talk about the tolerance and withdrawal symptoms of caffeine.
When you consume caffeine regularly, your body develops a tolerance to it. Symptoms of caffeine withdrawal can be observed in 24 hours of the last dose and may last from 2 days to 1 week. Symptoms can include headache, irritability, muscle pain, nausea, depression, fatigue, depending on a person's caffeine consumption habits. These withdrawal symptoms can range from being barely noticeable to quite extreme levels. Of course, the source of caffeine does matter. Black tea and coffee are good choices as they also contain powerful antioxidant. When it comes to soda and other soft drinks, you might want to try cutting on that, because soft drinks contain less caffeine but they are loaded with sugar, which is harmful for your health.
What do you think? what is your choice of caffeine? Coffee, black tea or soft drinks? Let us know in the comment section below. And do not forget to share and subscribe. And please press the bell icon.
Bye bye Tata, hasta la vista. ये था ज्ञान आज का. आपको पसंद आया तो रख लीजिए, अगर नहीं आया तो कमेंट सेक्शन में बता दीजिए, कमेंट ही बढ़ जाएंगे हमारे. बहुत दिक्कत होती है भाई, ये YouTube ना शेयर नहीं कर रहा हमारा कंटेंट को.